Yo, what's up, guys? This is Installer here. I'm bringing you a pretty shitty gameplay of me on Favela Free For All. I go 30-6, and you can see I'm sniping again. I'm playing Modern Warfare 2 again. I seem to be really enjoying it. This video is a few days old. I'm back into Modern Warfare 3. I just felt like playing Modern Warfare 2 for a few days. It was really interesting. But you can see I'm already sniffling in this commentary. I don't know why I get like little sniffles. After I do like activities or something, it's really annoying. I like get a cold or something. I don't really have a cold. It's just I have the sniffles. So, so please pardon that. That's me being polite for once. So yeah, if you guys have seen the Kenny versus Spenny commentary, Kenny Hotz himself commented on it, and I was pretty pumped about that because he's like my idol. He's the best person ever. He's fucking hilarious. So he commented on it, just saying nice comment or a nice review, and I'm not even sure if he watched it, but if he did, that's pretty cool. It's my views on that video have shot up by like at least 50. It was at like 60 or 70 views before. Now it's at 120 since he commented on it. I don't even know how that happened, but it has like 7 likes, which is like the most I've ever had. That's just completely awesome. 130 views doesn't seem like, or 120 views doesn't seem like a lot to you guys, but to me, that's incredible. Like, I normally average 40 or 50, and I get 120 on that. That just blew my mind after he commented on that. It blew up. So, you'll be seeing more gameplays from me in the future. I'm probably going to upload a commentary every 3, maybe 4 days. If you guys want to see more from me in the future, like maybe 2 or 3 days, just comment and I'll see what I can do. But I never really have much to talk about in my commentaries, so except for fuck, I need to stop smoking. Just kidding, I don't smoke. But there's actually something I want to talk about tonight. It's this commentary. I was just at a broomball game, and it's like house league, so nothing ever really happens. It's just like these I don't even know how to say it, these 3 teams that just play against each other every Friday or Saturday, and nothing ever happens. There's no hitting or anything. It's just we get together and play. It's so tonight there are these 2 like quiet guys that nobody even knows what their voice sounds like. But after he got off, I was just sitting there on the bench because I'm a bench warmer. So after he comes off, he's like, "Oh, if that guy says one more thing, I'm gonna fucking kill him." And I'm like, whoa, that's what his voice sounds like. So that's when I knew he was mad, because he actually said something about it. So then whenever I'm back on the ice, I'm like running into the corner because somebody dumped it down there. And I see nobody's chasing me. So I'm like, what the heck? I was almost about to score, even though that never happens. But I was going in front of the net and I see nobody's chasing me. So I'm like, what the heck? So I look back and I see there's these 2 guys fighting, just like going at it, just fists like on their faces and just completely, I don't even know how to say it. It was one of the most awesome things I've ever seen in broomball, because there's never a fight. I've been playing broomball for like 5 years now, maybe, and I think I've only seen 2 fights. It was fucking exciting. I wanted to congratulate him, but my dad's a coach, so I didn't want my dad to be like, "No, that was a bad thing," or something like that. So it was a really exciting broomball game. These 2 guys that never talk just start randomly fighting. So now I know, like, never to chirp him or anything, because he'll, like, shoot me in the face or something. And his dad's, like, the owner of the league or something. And he coaches provincials for the midget team. I don't even know if you guys know what I'm talking about, but, yeah, his dad's, so, like, high-powered in the league. So he only got 1 game suspension, even though it should be, like, 5. And if you fight again, you're, like, out for the season. So, like, he got lucky that his dad's the whatever he is. I don't even know. But, yeah, he would have gotten a lot more trouble. And they're both older than me. I'm, like, the youngest in the league, so I don't even know why I can even do anything. But it was pretty freaking awesome that he actually did that. Last thing I wanted to talk about was trick shots on Modern Warfare 3. I don't know about you guys, but it seems to be a lot harder. I haven't really been playing Search lately, but the trick shots, just I wasn't even good at them on Modern Warfare 3, so I don't see why I could do them on or Modern Warfare 2, so I don't see them why I could do them on Modern Warfare 3. I've seen, like, the trickshotting has gone down a lot more, and the trickshotting clans have stayed on Modern Warfare 2 just because they're so hard on Modern Warfare 3. So, yeah, you probably won't be seeing any of those from me in the future, so I'm just going to be keeping it to competitive or just pretty much that, or pubs. So, yeah, this is... Hope you like this. Comment, favorite, subscribe, like it. I'm going on too long here, so I'm going to peace it out, guys. See ya.